abnormal uterine bleeding can refer to either heavy menstrual periods or bleeding that happens in between periods. Any bleeding in a woman who is menopausal and not on hormone therapy is abnormal, and we need to investigate that and figure out why it's occurring. In women who are on hormone therapy, we still need to evaluate that, although most commonly that's related to the hormone therapy. To evaluate abnormal bleeding in a woman who is postmenopausal, we rely on sampling the endometrium to obtain tissue from the endometrial cavity and send that biopsy to a pathologist to make sure about issues related to endometrial cancers or precancers. Abnormal bleeding that happens in a postmenopausal woman is related to endometrial cancer only about 10% of the time, but when that bleeding occurs, that's sort of the thing that you need to make sure that it's not related to endometrial or uterine lining cancer. Treatments for abnormal uterine bleeding will be sort of age dependent and based on the severity of it. You know, if it's very mild, sometimes observation is okay, but for women who need treatment, there's a range of therapies from birth control pills, which may be given cyclically, or we might consider a progesterone-releasing IUD, what's called the Mirena IUD. Another option that's available is endometrial ablation. With endometrial ablation, a device is advanced through the cervix and into the uterine cavity, and contact is made through the whole endometrial cavity to bring energy of some sort. In the case of NovaSure, it's radio frequency, but the idea is to destroy or damage those endometrial glands so that they can't regenerate. So a woman will maintain her normal ovarian function. She'll still have hormonal function just as she did before, but there's just no response with this uterine lining to build up and have a period each month, or the period is greatly diminished. So fibroids can happen in the muscular wall of the uterus, and they can even be pretty large as long as they're not close to the interior wall of the uterus and really not cause a problem. But if the fibroid is close to the inside lining of the uterus, what's called a submucosal fibroid, then it interferes with that uterine lining sort of squeezing off and the glands closing when she's trying to stop bleeding with a period. And these kind are the ones that will cause problems. Abnormal bleeding is such a common problem in women throughout their reproductive age range and into their menopausal years even, and can be a source of such frustration. But the good news is that we have lots of therapies that we haven't had in the past. We just need to evaluate the cause of why it's happening, and they can offer those women a choice about how they prefer to be treated.